Welcome back. In this video, we'll walk you through how Contoso Flooring is securing all of their completed customer jobs and then storing that information in SharePoint Online for safekeeping in the cloud. Take note, before we get started, to use this connector, you'll need an account with Mahimbi. So if you don't have one, you'll want to sign up there first. In Microsoft Flow's editor, the Mahimbi actions show up in the same way as other built-in services such as SharePoint, Dropbox, and Salesforce. All Mahimbi workflow actions that customers are already used to, including various conversions, merging, watermarking, security, and OCR actions, are displayed in the Flow's list of actions. Instead of talking more about it, let's just jump in and you can see it in action. Okay, first, let's navigate over to My Flows, and then let's click Create from Blank. Now, imagine, for this flow, the scenario is going to be that when Sharon, the installer for Contoso, uploads or creates a document in a certain folder in her OneDrive for Business, that file is then automatically sent off to the Mahimbi service to turn it into a PDF file. The accounts payable team can then have a standard format to interact with work orders, to keep them neatly organized in a central location, and so they can have them in the cloud, accessible on all their devices in all the places where they have an active internet connection. So now from here, let's go ahead and add our trigger. Since Sharon is going to be storing her files in OneDrive for Business, let's go ahead and search OneDrive for Business. We can see it pop up here. Now, let's choose the trigger when a new file is created. Okay. From here, we need to choose the OneDrive folder that we want to be searching. And Sharon's folder is called Finished Documents. So we'll go ahead and select that. Now we want to choose another action. Let's go ahead and search for Mahimbi, which is going to do our conversion for us. And then let's choose the actions Convert Document. Let's make sure we transfer the file name and the file content. Remember how we've been using this dynamic content picker? You're gonna see that in Flow, we use that quite often, and we use it again here. So what we've done is, when a file is created in OneDrive in a specific folder called Finished Documents, the document will then be converted to a PDF. And so the file name and the file content will both be brought along with us. Okay, now we have two steps done, but we're not quite finished. Let's also now tell Flow that once it's done converting this data, we want it to move the new PDF copy to another place, so it's actually where the accounts payable team can get to it easily. So let's go ahead and add another action and choose SharePoint, because that's where the accounts payable team wants the data to live. My text of AirPoint seemed to work there. So now for actions, we're going to choose SharePoint and create file. From here, we'll need to specify where our file lives. Here's my SharePoint site. And we'll also need to specify the folder on where we want it to actually go. We want it to go into the PDF finished files folder. And now, to pass along the proper information, we need to use some more dynamic content. So, for the file name, we want to use the converted file name. And so, we can see right here, name of the file input without the extension. This is what Mahimbi has created for us. And now, a little trick, we actually need to add .pdf to the end of this, so that way our file actually saves as a PDF in SharePoint. And then we need to choose the dynamic content piece of file content, and we want to use our processed file content. So again, we have an actual PDF file. And so from here, let's go ahead and click on Create Flow. And that's it. We're done. And so now let's go add a file to our OneDrive and see if it converts to a PDF and then moves it to my SharePoint folder automatically. So let's go ahead here into our finished documents, and we will add some files. I'm just going to go ahead and add any random doc right now for the purpose of the demo. We'll see, here it is, uploaded into the finished files folder. Now, let's go ahead and click into our flow. So here's the flow we just created. Now, if we click on this little eye right here, we can see all of our flow runs. And so we can see that now the flow is actually running. We dropped a new file in. We can see 5 seconds. Oh, it converted the document. There it is. And now we'll wait for our last step to finish. And now it says it created the file in SharePoint. So let's go here to SharePoint to our PDF finished files folder. Let's do a quick refresh. And there it is. Flow took the document, converted it to a PDF, and moved it into another folder, saving you tons of time, saving you tons of emails, people asking you where stuff is. And so as you can see, it's off and running. Thanks for joining us for another video on how you can use Microsoft Flow.